Sanjay, what are the breathing tests for asthma and how do they work?
So the most common breathing test we're going to use in asthma is going to be a test known as spirometry. Now, what that test is that you take a big deep breath in and then you blow out as hard and long and fast as possible. What the test tells us is how the air is moving through the breathing tubes. Now, we know asthma is a disease in which the breathing tubes get narrowed or constricted. So we can then measure how this airflow is it normal or is it altered? And in asthma, what happens is that this flow of air will be slower than what it should be. What's interesting is that in mild asthma, and especially if the patient is not having an attack, this test can be entirely normal. So if the spirometry is normal, that does not mean that you don't have asthma, that the patient can still have asthma. On the other hand, if it's abnormal, that tells us that the asthma is getting into the persistent categories, you know, what we call moderate or severe persistent asthma. And that's very important because that also guides the treatment that we offer or we start with in the management of asthma. Besides spirometry, a simpler version of that is a peak flow measurement. And that's a very simple test. You kind of just blow, you know, take a deep breath in and just blow. And this peak flow is also, again, gives us similar information about the flow of air in the breathing tubes. And that we actually use to monitor patients at home. You know, so for some of my patients, I'll offer them a peak flow meter and then they can measure it once or twice a day to see how their asthma is doing, how the lungs are doing. Another test we sometimes use in asthma is something known as the methacholine challenge test. Now that's kind of big words, but essentially what we do in this test is give a medication which narrows the airways and we give it in tiny doses and increase the dose. And we see how much of a dose does it take for it to narrow the airways. And what we find is that in asthma patients, it takes a much lower dose than in those patients who do not have asthma. Now this I only use when there is kind of confusion about the diagnosis or the asthma is presenting in an unusual way. For example, we have something known as cough variant asthma where patients will present only with cough. So then, you know, you wonder what's going on and then we may do this test to make sure that this is asthma or it's not asthma. And finally, there are these other tests for lung function. They are known as things like lung volume measurement or diffusion capacity measurement. And those, again, we usually don't require them in asthma diagnosis or management of asthma. But when there is confusion about the diagnosis, for example, you have an asthmatic who smoked and may have permanent damage to his lung, then I would like to know what the lung volumes are, what's his capacity to exchange oxygen, because that may be quite altered in those situations.